mean they're just excited. You know, we all sit in the hotel rooms or someplace and watch those two great games last night, and it's on our doorstep, and here it is. And so you take this, the reality that the season has started, and then you combine that with, you know, we get a bunch of 20-year-olds that you know, are really excited, almost like childlike excited, and I say that in a great way. And, you know, two important players haven't played a second of NBA basketball, really, yet. And so it's a good vibe, it's an exciting vibe.
But it's a big moment for Australian basketball as well, with Ben Simmons' debut.
I think Australian basketball has had lots of big moments recently. You know, I coached over there for 17 years and married one. And the evolution of Australian basketball is incredibly respected around the world. And you start seeing the volume of NCAA athletes, and you start seeing the volume of now NBA athletes. It's Ben Simmons is for sure an exciting part of that, and there's a lot of good things going on basketball-wise in Australia.
Imagine your mom is sort of loves the fact that you got this new young team, and obviously all want them to stay healthy. In your mind, you know, how do Markel, Joel, and Ben become like a bona fide big three in the NBA? How does that happen? What is time?
Just to have a really disciplined teaching approach with them. I've been lucky to see, you know, four NBA championships and Hall of Fame players and NBA MVPs and All-Stars, and players remind you and teach you a lot. And I feel that what I have to do to help them is to coach them and to really coach them and give them truths, our truths at times, because the discipline of it all weighs up into their health, into an educated player, into a poised player that can deal with time and score and react to the moment in a mature way. But that's growth, you know. And so I love the challenge, but I really, you know, feel a tremendous opportunity and responsibility to help them navigate what I think are going to be great NBA careers.
Is there a balance that's struck between obviously the being teams tonight, but for Ben and Mark in particular, experiencing this for the first time and savoring what's, you know, probably going to be an important moment for them in the first game?
I don't understand that question.
Is there, like, what do you want them to take out of tonight?
I want them to go slow. I want everybody to play the game, you know, at a pace that can let their minds not rush. Now, that's easy to say. Probably it's not going to happen. But, you know, I got to just remind them, this is a 82-game, you know, long journey. And the tone of my voice, I hope will help them hear that, like how I handle things. I hope to help them better understand that. But it's a long haul. It's a long haul, and I'm always mindful of that with a team in general, and especially this one.
How do you communicate to a guy like maybe less than Markel, but even like Joel, like the minutes restriction is like good for you long term? When a guy is so competitive and wants to play, so how do you?
I mean, down he knows it. You know, like I said before, sometimes he feels like he lets down the fans. You know, if he's not going to go fight a little bit, and it's part of who he is. And we have a fantastic medical group behind me that is very prideful, very thoughtful, very intelligent on why we do what we do. And so, you know, handling all that from a positive perspective for Joe, you know, he wants to go play, and it's my job to like use the minutes as wisely as I can, but certainly help better explain to him that, and he knows this, he understands it is for his best interest.